Now, this is something very, very interesting for all of us who have senior citizens or elderly members in their family. In the United States, an estimated 5.4 million people have been diagnosed with Alzheimer's disease. The figure is ever growing and it is rapid with the aging population. One of them was Steve Newport. His wife, Mary Newport, was a doctor. Dr. Mary learned that her husband had severe Alzheimer's disease. When the doctor examined her husband at the hospital, he asked Steve to paint a clock. Instead, he drew a few circles and then drew a few figures without any logic. It was not like a clock at all. The doctor pulled her aside and said, "Your husband is already on the verge of severe Alzheimer's disease." It turned out that it was a test of whether a person had Alzheimer's disease. Dr. Mary was very upset at that time. But as a doctor, she would not just give up. She began to study the disease. She found out Alzheimer's disease was associated to glucose deficiency to the brain. Her research says the dementia of the elderly is like having diabetes in the head. Before one has the symptoms of diabetes or Alzheimer's disease, the body has already had problems for 10 to 20 years. According to Dr. Mary's study, Alzheimer's disease is very similar to type 1 or type 2 diabetes. The cause is also insulin imbalance, metabolic disorder. Because insulin has a problem, it prevents the brain cells from absorbing glucose. Glucose is the nutrition of brain cells. Without glucose, brain cells die. As it turns out, these high quality proteins are the cells that feed our body. But nutrition for our brain cell is glucose. As long as we have mastered the source of these two kinds of food, we are the masters of our own health. The next question is, where to find glucose? It cannot be the ready-made glucose that we buy from the store. It is not from fruits such as grapes. She started looking for alternatives. The alternative nutrients for brain cells are ketones. Ketones are necessary in brain cells. Ketones cannot be found in vitamins. Coconut oil contains triglycerides. After the triglycerides in coconut oil is consumed, it is metabolized into ketones in the liver. This is the alternative nutrient for brain cells. After the scientific verification, Dr. Mary added coconut oil to her husband's food. After only 2 weeks, when he went to the hospital again to do painting and the clock test, the progress was amazing. Dr. Mary said, "At that time, I thought, has God heard my prayers? Wouldn't it be coconut oil that worked? But there is no other way. Anyways, it's better to continue taking the coconut oil." Dr. Mary was now part of the traditional medical practice base. She clearly knew the capabilities of traditional medicine. 3 weeks later, the third time she took him to do a smart clock test, the performance was better than the last time. This progress was not only intellectual but also emotional and physical. Dr. Mary said he could not do his running, but now he can run. He could not read for a year, now a half, but he can read again, now after taking coconut oil for 3 months. Her husband's action had already begun to change. He did not speak in the mornings. Now she noticed a lot of changes. Now after he gets up, he is spirited, talking and laughing. He drinks water himself and takes utensils for himself on his own. On the surface, these are very simple daily tasks, but only those who have come to the clinic or have demented relatives at home can experience the joy. It is not easy to see such progress. After frying the greens and onions in coconut oil, making cakes with coconut, after taking 3 to 4 tablespoons of coconut oil per meal, 2-3 months later, the eyes too can now focus normally. Her studies prove that coconut oil can really improve the problem of dementia in the elderly. Apply coconut oil to bread. When coconut cream is used, the taste is unexpectedly good. Young people can also use it for maintenance of health and prevention, and can improve if they have symptoms of dementia. Dementia is caused because nutrients cannot be transported to brain cells, and nutrients must be passed from the body to the brain by insulin. Especially for diabetic patients, it's not easy to get insulin secretion. Nutrition cannot get to the brain when brain cells are starved to death. They are deprived of intelligence. Coconut oil contains medium chain triglyceride, which can supply nutrient to the brain without using insulin. So it can improve Alzheimer's disease and Parkinson's disease. After having listened to this beautiful, beautiful insight on elderly, how we can save them from Alzheimer's or Parkinson's, request you to please percolate this and reach out to as many homes as possible, because I believe that if India is 40% youth, there is 60% we need to take care of, and imagine what the world would have. Please reach out to Maxim. Thank you.